Hey guys, Triple B here. We're covering a new deck coming out of Shrouded Fables, and that is Palafin EX. It was requested in the comments of one of my videos by a user, SquirrelTCG. So if you're watching this, cheers, buddy. I appreciate the idea. He threw me a list to give a go. We did make a couple of tweaks just because there were some cards that I felt needed to be in higher counts and some cards that I felt like kind of needed to be in the deck but weren't currently in it, like Luminous Energy wasn't in there, and it just kind of helps fix up some type coverages for you, as well as making another attacker possible that wasn't initially in the build. But for this deck, the main attacker obviously being Palafin EX. So it's a pretty big beefy boy. He's got 340 HP on a stage 1 Pokemon, which is a little unheard of. It's more HP than stage 2 Pokemon actually have, right? Charizard EX is what, 330? 330? I don't know. We're doing this live while I'm on Twitch, so if someone in Twitch wants to correct me, that's always appreciated. Also, yeah, if you're watching us on YouTube, I stream over on Twitch, guys. There's a link in the comments. Link in the description, I mean. That's the right word. You go jump on that, and you can hang out with me when I do this live. But yeah, so 340 HP, pretty big target. It's difficult for opponents to deal with. The tricky thing about it, though, you're doing 250 damage, so you're also not necessarily taking one-shots into other large targets. You can tank a hit, though, and then just kind of like give them a 1-2 combo. The other tricky thing about Palafin is the ability on it, which normally abilities are a good thing. In this case, it's kind of a tricky one though, because its ability, Hero Spirit, makes it so it can only come into play off the effect of Palafin's Zero to Hero ability. So there's a single prize Palafin with that ability that literally just says, once during your turn, when this Pokemon moves from the active spot to your bench, you can search your deck for a Palafin EX and swap it out with it. So it keeps any damage counters on it, energies, tools, all those things stay in play, but it's just going to change into the EX. It does make it so that this Palafin's back in your deck, and you can evolve another Finizen into it later in the game, so that's very useful. But other than that, everything's staying on it same as. The tricky thing about this, though, obviously you need ways to pivot it around. So the way we're going to get around that, we obviously have Switch card. It's a good card. Gets your guy out of the active, gets it to the bench, makes it so that Palafin can become, well, bigger Palafin, which is appreciated. But the better way we can do it is a very repetitive way, since the other thing about Palafin is Giga Impact. You can't attack during the following turns. We need a way to consistently bounce it out of the active. We're going to use Morpeko and Pecherant EX. So Morpeko has an ability that makes it so it has free retreat as long as it doesn't have any energy attached to it, which is really nice. So if we can get this in the active, we can get it back to the bench without any issues. That means a switch from Palafin into a Morpeko and then Morpeko back into Palafin, you're good. Or you can even just be using Pecherant with it, whose ability lets you move a dark Pokemon from your bench into the active spot at the trade-off of poisoning it. So the game plan is you have Palafin, the single prize one, this one, sat in your active spot. You're then going to trigger Pecherant. Pecherant's going to move Morpeko to the active. Because Palafin's moved to the bench, it evolves into the EX. Because Morpeko won't have any energy on it, it has free retreat, and then you just retreat into the Palafin EX and just punch your opponent in the face, and yeah, Bob's your uncle. And if he's not, then I don't know, maybe George or Ted? I don't know. If you don't have an uncle, I'm sorry, you should... They're neat. Having an uncle's fun. Back on track, though. Palafin EX isn't the only attacker in the deck. So Morpeko technically does have an attack. You're never attaching energy to that, though, so it's... Ignore him. He's not an attacker. The Pecherant, on the other hand, can be, though. So for 2 dark energy, it does a multiplier of 60 for every prize card that your opponent's taken, meaning late in the game, it can be a pretty good threat. If they've taken 4 prizes, you go 6 times 4, 240. You're taking out some decent things, right? Like you could boss up a utility Pokemon like a Squawkabilly or a Rotom or your Lumineon. Knock it out with this, you're in an all right spot. Or if you do kind of prize map to the point where your opponent's taken 5 prizes, like they've knocked out a single prize Pokemon, then they've knocked out 2 Palafins, all of a sudden you're doing 300 damage. If you can boost that just a little bit higher, you could take out something big like a Charizard EX. And we do have a way to boost that by Kieran. So Kieran has the option of either acting as a switch card, which is very useful because we can use it for Palafin, but it also has the option to make it so you do 30 extra damage into Pokemon V and Pokemon EX, meaning that your Palafins can get up to 280 to one-shot Pokemon V-Star, and your Pecherant can theoretically get up to 330 to knock out, well, big stage 2 EX Pokemon. Ironically, you'll never get to a point where you can knock out another Palafin EX because we have 340 and that's some awkward math. But it is what it is. The other attacker we do have in here, though, is another Palafin. So the single prize Palafin, a different single prize Palafin to the other single prize Palafin we already talked about. This one has Jet Punch. So for one water energy, you can do 30 damage to the active Pokemon and then 30 damage to one of your opponent's bench Pokemon. So there will be situations where it's just like, you want to try and set up numbers for your Palafin EX, right? Like you do 250 damage. It's like, well, to get into a Pokemon V-Star without using Kieran, hey, can I just put 30 damage on a bench Lugia? It's like, yeah, go for it. Why not? The other thing on here, we do have an attack for 210 damage, but you can only use it if this moved from the bench to the active spot. So it's Palafin's whole thing is just like moving around, it like swimming. It's a fish, I guess it kind of makes sense. So you're just kind of going with the flow. But 210 damage on a single prize Pokemon, it's nothing to laugh at. It's pretty solid. Obviously, you want to use Palafin EX when you can, but this to kind of mess up that prize mapping so that we can have that Pecherant play later in the game, it's an awesome addition to be able to go into. And for the final attacker, which, well, I guess technically there's two more, we've got Monkey Dory. So there is Luminous Energy, which can count for the psychic energy in the attack cost, and then just chuck any other energy on there. You can do 60 damage and confuse your opponent, which might buy you a bit of time when you're in a pinch. It's mostly in here for the ability though, Adrenabrain, which allows you to move 3 damage counters from one of your Pokemon onto your opponent's Pokemon to kind of help fix up some math off Palafin and heal it a little bit. You need a dark energy on there though, so we do have basic ones in there so you can search them out with Earthen Vessel as well as Luminous Energy, which we already mentioned. And there's also Pheasant Dippity EX in here, which technically can attack, but you do need 3 energy on it to get it charged up, and we don't have a quick way to accelerate that out, so it's mostly in here for the ability as well. If your opponent knocked out one of your Pokemon on their previous turn, you can just straight up draw into 3 cards. There's not a lot of draw options in this deck, so having a reliable one that can just be sat on your bench and just go, oh, you knocked out one of my things? Cool, I really need a Boss's Orders this turn, and this is going to draw me into it. Thanks, and then you just go boss for game, bop them. It's good times. The other way to reliably get into cards like Boss's Orders is there's Luminion V in here. Bench it, get a supporter card from your deck, and you're having a great time. The ways that we can reliably get into this, since we have a bunch of water Pokemon, you've probably noticed we have a Rita. If you're running a water deck, you have a Rita in it. It gets you water Pokemon, any water Pokemon, so you can get your basics, you can get your evolutions, and gets you an item, which is really useful. The rest of the deck, though, I feel like it's kind of just standard staples you guys have seen a dozen times and don't really need to run through for. If you haven't seen Buddy Buddy Poffin and you're new to the game, it gets you 2 Pokemon with 70 HP or less. It's getting your Finizens, it's getting your Marpecos. Great card. Earthen Vessel, dish a card, get 2 energy, and get you into your dark energies to help out into getting Monkey Dory online or just get your water energy in a pinch. The Forest Seal Stone is in here. It's mainly just because you have Luminion, so Luminion gets you a supporter, and then Forest Seal Stone allows you to get any other card off your Luminion, just adding some more value to it. And then obviously Lost Vacuum in here, helping out into matchups where your opponent's going to have a little bit too much health, right? So Palafin EX doing 250 damage, you're going to knock out Raging Bolt EXs in most circumstances, but if they have a Bravery Charm on there, you're not anymore. So you just go, all right, I've hit you, you didn't die, that's fine. Then on your next turn, you go, Arita, get another Palafin out, get a Lost Vacuum, you remove the Ancient Boost Capsule or remove the Bravery Charm off their Raging Bolt that they weren't expecting to be dead. All of a sudden, it's gone. They put a new thing in the active, you punch it in the face, you take 4 prizes in one turn, you can quickly swing matches that way and it'll get them off guard. Obviously, you could just remove the Boost Capsule before you hit them too, like that option's there. I just like, you know, coming out of left field and surprising people, it's always fun and seems to frustrate them, which, you know, that makes me happy. So we do this surprise plays when we can. But now I'm kind of just rambling. That's pretty much it for the deck. I hope you enjoy it. If you do, the list will be in the description of the video so you can give it a try for yourself. And also, yeah, if you haven't already, boop that subscribe button so you can keep up with more videos and hit that like button. Comment down below to feed the algorithm monster. But now let's hop on ladder and see how we go with this. All right, finding 2 more Pecco. We have 2 in the deck. Not ideal to start them out. The Iron Thorns is coming out. As long as this is in the active, Pokemon with a rule box have no abilities. That's okay. So Morpeko still has an ability. The Palafins will still have an ability. Let's get one of each. Right, because he's the one that has the ability we care about, Zero to Hero. And then put this Pokemon into play only with the effect. But he's not in play, so it would be, that goes from hand. It should be fine, it should be fine. Yeah, we'll do that, we'll attach an energy, pass. next turn we have Arita, so we can get the Palafin out. We've got Switch, we've got Free Retreat off from our Pekko. We should be fine. I think we're kind of just good to go. So apologies. Had some cards drop. Was sleeving up a deck before hopping on stream. Not Pokemon. They just get the Crushing Hammer off on us. And the Judge, okay. Well, this hand's a lot worse. We were cooking a second ago, and now we are not doing so hot. Okay, so they've got the tool, they've got an energy, DTE, and they can start swinging. Hopefully we can hit an Arita off this. Judge shuffled, so there's no need for us to try and shuffle the deck again. Beautiful. Get into it. He's got Free Retreat. Use this, get into a Switch. Or is it when that comes into the active? Should read this again. Once during your turn, when this Pokemon moves from the active spot to the bench. Okay, so I need to be able to pivot. Or do I just do the evolution? This Free Retreats, that pivots. Yeah, we don't have a way to do both. Don't have a way to do both right now, at least. Almost should have retreated into it, just knowing that they wouldn't be able to get an attack off last turn. Although with Pecherant, can we get there? How do we sequence this? Free Retreat into this, Pecherant bounces him out, that moves him, he can evolve, we switch back into this. But we have no ability because of that. Right. God damn it, I... Okay, let's go back into more Pekko. Yeah, we'll use Zero to Hero. Zen, why use Pecherant? Pecherant just has the ability that it can bounce something back active, right? So Morpeko is Free Retreat. We could Free Retreat into Palafin, which needs to move from the active to the bench to be able to evolve. So we'd have Pecherant there to just be able to bounce itself into the active, swapping out with this to trigger the evolution, and then switch back into it. You need to be able to maneuver like a couple steps. So it gets a little bit weird. But yeah, that was an oversight on my part. Just, yeah. Kind of cluing out for a second. Why bench it now? Because I'm a dumbass. long story short, yeah. No, I can own that one. Got too focused on figuring out the combo on my end and forgot what the opponent was doing. Like, if they don't get another Iron Thorns benched, we just knock that out. Yeah, Free Retreat, coming to the active, punch him in the face. All right, 250, GG. Iron Thorn beat. It's an easy game. Yeah, we played through the misplays. We got there. It could have gone horribly if they, you know, had some stuff. Like boss, right? They boss. They were doing what? 140 plus 20, but then minus 20 because of the DTE. Doubles to 28. Okay, so we do tank that. All right, I'm not minding this list. Oh, I'm not minding the deck. The list, I still want to tweak some things, but yeah, we'll give it another game or two. Zen, Thorns is actually one of Palafin's easiest matchups. Yeah, like as long as they have DTE, they're not one-shotting us. We can one-shot them. Our ability, we don't really care about because it's from hand that the ability triggers, not from being in play. Yeah, I think we do go first. advice coming in. How you doing, man? How's the rest of the king? Being raided by the king. Welcome, Lyak. Welcome, Freeth. Is that Lyak? Lyak's ogre. You an ogre pawn? You an ogre pawn main, Lyak? Tough game is back to the lab. That's fair. I don't really want to start either of these. I guess the Pecherant. Yeah, I feel like Kingdra's one of those decks, right? It has a lot of potential. But I feel like with where the meta's at, it might be a little bit too slow. Like, it'll always be a B or T tier. E or T. I can say the good words. B or C tier. There we go. Deck. But I don't know that it has enough really at the moment. We'll just grab that one. Need to be able to switch into it. It's like we grab that or we get the more Pekko. I guess I should have used Heavy Ball to see what was in there first, right? One more Pekko is in the prizes, it looks like. So we use Heavy Ball, get a more Pekko out. At least I'm pretty sure we run two. Beautiful. Ooh. No, we get the more Pekko. We get the more Pekko. Because I don't think they're going to be taking a knockout first turn. We can proc this. We bring more Pekko to the active. Then I can go more Pekko, switch into this. So if I can evolve, that can become a Palafin. We can use this again, bring more Pekko to the active, triggering the evolution, and then just kind of bounce that back in and go. Should be all right. So if you guys haven't seen Palafin EX before, probably because PTCGL had it broken for ages. But it's a really interesting stage one card. So 340 HP. The trick is, though, it can only come into play with the effect of Palafin's zero to hero ability. So like there's a single prize one that when it's in the active spot, if it moves to the bench, you can evolve into this. The attack on here, though, one water energy, 250 damage. It's not bad. Like you can get going pretty quick. You have a lot of HP on there. So it's definitely an interesting concept to play around with. A user submitted a list, so we're giving it a go, seeing if we're going to make any tweaks, but I want to do 2 to 3 games with their list first before we just like completely cut it down. But so far, liking the concept of it. I feel like there's some ways we can kind of modify things though, like boost damage up a little bit more, boost up health a little bit more, like go for either a tankier or more aggressive build, but definitely suss it out. Got a head off ice. All good, man. All good. Thank you very much. Might need him. Looks like we're into Kingdra. Hey, Sebo, how you doing, buddy? Milky, how are you? You cooking up something for Friday? Do they not play a supporter? I don't even know that I want to Iono them. Like, I do want to Iono them because I kind of need to get out of this hand. But at the same point, I could just Luminion to get into Irida to guaranteed get the pieces, right? And then I'm not helping them set up. Right, like we get Irida. Irida gets us... Is Ace back in here? No, it is prized. Dang. So I was like, if we can get Prime Catcher, bring up their Horsey, knock it out, we're in a pretty good spot. Palafin we need is in here though. So what item do I get off this then? Might even just be Buddy Buddy to get more Palafins out. And theoretically, we can attach energy on that to bounce it out. But let's grab this. It's just a Jet Punch too. It's 30-30. That's not enough. Yeah, let's grab these. So, proc Pecherant, bounce more Pekko to the active, deck is poisoned, this can evolve. I love how it's from deck too, that's pretty big. Use this, get some more little dudes. Pivot back into this and then punch it in the face. I can be charging up one of these. And the other thing we could be doing is like chucking a dark energy on this just to have it as a backup attacker. Been in the works for about 3 weeks. You just hope it can live up to the testing. Oh, okay, okay. Any leaks or any hints? Are you keeping it up your sleeve? Got to figure out a deck for Friday. I feel like I always leave it to the last minute. It's usually like, 20 minutes before stream. Okay, I'll throw together a list. It'll be fine. It'll be fine. There's the 1 week I just took Jab's list and I was like, that's good. So what did I run last week? Cooper Aja. I tried out Cooper Aja from Shrouded Fable and honestly enjoyed it. I really enjoyed it. Definitely some tweaks I could do to the list, but had a lot of fun with it. For anyone that's come by from Vice's stream and isn't familiar with our Friday night streams, on Friday night, I run a tournament called Budget Build Battles, and it's all about just building single prize decks. So it's single prize decks, no rule box cards, so no A-specs, no Radiance, no Vs, no EXs, and there is a limitation of only 2 copies of a card with the same name in your deck, so it makes for some really interesting like deck building potential. We've seen completely different decks in the top 8 pretty much every week. There's been a couple like mainstays, like there's one player that's been running Torterra week after week and like been doing pretty solid with it. Also like metal box decks have been making a good showing and ancient box decks, but there's always, I'd say at least 4 unique decks in the top 8. Want a hint? It's going to be very similar to the one in standard format in concept at least. Okay, okay. Not control, is it? You're not going to be running like Snorlax, are you? Ooh. Okay. So they've got 310 HP, which does make it a little bit awkward. We're not able to one-shot it. I'd like to be able to gust that up, but obviously we can't do that at the moment. We can get around the limitation of not being able to attack though, right? So we go Pecherant, bounce more Pekko into the active. That removes that effect. Retreat. Go back into it. We're good. Off this, like seeing that they didn't really do anything last turn, like I guess they got the Arena play, but like in terms of their hand, we haven't seen that much. So like they have this out, but they don't necessarily have energy out to do anything. So I think we do just go Arena, get another Palafin out to get another Palafin EX out. And then I'm kind of thinking we grab Counter Catcher. So don't need anything else at the moment, do I? I guess more energy wouldn't be a bad call. But yeah, I'm kind of leaning towards Counter Catcher. We hit them. If they manage to get enough energy to take a knockout, we at least have Counter Catcher. We can bring up the Baxcalibur, we can take it out, and then we just have to deal with that Kingdra that's going to be weakened. We'll chuck an energy on here just so it is like one attachment away from being a threat, and we'll just swing into this. Blueberry, you're cooking another spicy deck with Shrouded Fable for the budget format. Ooh, love to hear it, Blueberry. What are you cooking up? Milky, that's not your job. That's for others in the control nation. Yeah, it's fair. That's fair. Control's been in one of those decks you like. I don't know. I like the concept of it, but I'm not a good enough player to confidently play it. Oh, okay. So we tank that. They have no hand. I think we do just knock this out then. Like, I don't need to muck around here. Pop that into the active. We'll just pivot. I'm not going to use the Iono. They currently have no hand. We're not going to give them a hand. Swing. Like, as much as I would like to Iono to get into different cards, I don't want to give my opponent different cards from their no cards. Like, you seem to be struggling. Here's 6 cards. No, that's fine. I'm in no rush. Yeah. Poor Kingdra. Open Finizen. We've got Arena. We can get into the Palafin if we need. We can get into Switch, bounce it into more Pekko. More Pekko, free retreat. Good to go. We got a game plan. Milky, you saw someone prize 4 rare candy in their Zard and Cinder. Bad times. Oh, we just top deck the switch. Beautiful. Let's put that down. Theoretically, I could put Monkey Dory in play already. I don't know that we need to, but it's like I could put that down to put Luminous on it, but no, I think we hold off. Hold off just on the mindset that I likely need to attach. Give me one sec. Likely need to attach this to one of the Finizens. Don't want to attach it just yet in case they do have potential to take a knockout first turn. I'm thinking Ogre Pond, potentially Ogre Pond Bolts, but definitely Ogre Pond. Yeah. That's an Ogre Pond. Zen, that's also skillish. You prized all your things that you needed to play the game. Just do better. Just play five rare kids. Oh, 100%. That's just ratioed. It's unfortunate because there's not a lot of ways to get things out of the prizes at the moment besides just taking prizes, right? Like, we have Heavy Ball, but it's only going to target your basics. LeViz, you love the Kingdra deck. It's so fun, but the meta is just way too fast. Yeah, it's kind of how it feels. By the time you get online, like, your opponent's just got multiple things out. I like the one where it's more so like leaning into the King's Orders, just because it's like, well, I'll get two Kingdras, get two Backscalibers, and you're good to go. But yeah, trying to keep up with a lot of the stuff, like into Ogre Pond, Raging Bolt, you're going to have a hard time. All right, off of this though, we go Arita, we do the thing. We get this. I have Switch already, but at the same point, I kind of want to get Rhyme Catcher. Yeah. Bench that, or not bench that, play that. Rhyme Catcher, we bring up their attacker. This goes to the active. Get to evolve him. Yes, I would like to use Zero to Hero. There we go. Attach, retreat, bonk. I've got Nest Ball. Do I go for another Finizen? Or I guess I could hold off to go for Pecherant. We'll hold off to go for Pecherant. Right, because Pecherant means a free way to bounce more Pekko in the active and retreat. I already have a second Finizen on the bench, so we're not really in a rush. And just gives us a little bit of flexibility. All right, easy. We just switch, retreat, bonk. Oh. Palafin can do things pretty fast. Oh, there's Pecherant. All right. Pop Finizen in the active. We're holding Pecherant, which is always good. So if we can get to the evolution and a more Pekko, we're fine. We've got Nest Ball, so more Pekko is easy enough to get. And then, yeah, we have the loop to get this evolved and then pivoted out. Seeing Pecherant on the opposing side, too. Oh, just top deck the Palafin. Love it. I think we get another Finizen out, though. Just to play it safe. Just in case it is the Donk one. And I'm going to hold. Right? Because if I chuck an energy on the bench, or I chuck an energy on the active, and it is the Donk version, and they just bring that one up, then we're digging for another energy. We only need one attachment to get online, so I think we're fine. Okie dokie. No way. So they're running it with Janine and Dark Patch? Yeah, so like shoes get dark in the bin. Dark Patch that on there. Janine, or even just double Dark Patch if you can. Pretty threatening if they get there. They do have the Janine. Love it. Nice. And half that 10 bucks was what? It was just some UEX, huh? Nice. Chef 10. I started playing, but you're not half bad and your friends don't play as much. Just wondering if you could test a deck. It's a mill deck and you could run something different. I don't really do viewer matches. Sorry, Chef. Or Chief. And like when I do, it's with people that have come by. So like, sorry, man, but yeah, when someone pops into the stream and the first thing they say is, I want to play a mill deck against you. I'm like, nah, man, I'm sorry. Okay, so we evolve into the Palafin. We put this on the bench. Literally just need to get into more Pekko. We're going to do 240. We take the knockout. Easy. We'll go for the Arita just so we can get a second Palafin. Not you. You. And we use this to get more Pekko and another Palafin. By Palafin, I mean Finizen. get that. Throw that down. And yeah, so we proc Pecherant, bring that active, trigger the ability. And we get the donk. Well, not donk. It's turn two and they have multiple bases. We get the knockout. No, I don't think he could upgrade Rotom V-Star with it. With which? Oh, with Shrouded Fable? Yeah, I don't know that there's too much for Rotom V-Star in Shrouded Fable. Maybe the new tool card where it's like at the end of your turn, you can attach an energy to it. Just so if you're in a pinch. Like setting something up, and it is another tool card you can loss them, but yeah, I don't think you really need it. Chief, how do you go about entering the raffle? So just exclamation raffle. That's all you need to do. Rotom seemed all right since a lot of players in your area are playing Lugia and you're running a Temple Sinnoh. You adapt to the meta. Like, if that's your meta, if your meta is lightning weak and it's just, hey, I can get free wins with this. Yeah, absolutely. Or is it done right now? Maybe it's done. It's done. That's why you guys can't enter right now. So, Deathlike, you still in chat? Are we doubling it or are you taking the codes? I need to set up a thing that it makes a sound when the raffle's done. Or you guys need to heckle me more when it says the raffle's done. Ah, they just scooped. Yeah, that's fair. I took out their main attacker. They're having a bad time. All right, we'll open the Finizen. That's what we like to see. We do have the Palafin for the zero to hero ability already. Love to see it. Fezzendipity in hand. Like, yeah, it's all right. I'd prefer more Pekko. We got ways. Goodbye. It is good Goomba. Chief, would I be willing to indulge in what? What are we talking about? Are you still asking about playing a match? I don't do stream, or I don't do viewer battles, bud. And like, no offense, but like, especially the first chat from somebody coming into my stream asking to play a game, it's a bit of a red flag. And especially when you say you want to play a meal. Just hop on ladder, man. Just test your deck out on ladder. It's one of those things of playing on ladder, there is literally nothing to lose playing ranked. Like, I'm not too sure why people get caught up in their ranked on this game. Like, if you grind games, you can get to Masters rank. I'm currently in Great League, mostly because I haven't really played ladder in the last, like, 2 months. And it resets every month and knocks you back a peg. Because we do a lot of custom matches for the Friday night tournament, so the budget build battle format, it's all just done as like friendly matches. It's not on ladder. That's one of the times where I guess I technically do viewer games, but yeah, I don't really see the purpose of hopping into a viewer match. No offense, man. If you have questions about like how to make your deck work a little bit better, or if you want me to play the deck on stream and let you know what I think of it, happy to do that. But doing a viewer battle, it's not really something I do. All right. What are we looking into? Duskull, Rotom. Any other clues here? Fire energy. Cool. It's Zard. Off this, though, I've already got that Palafin. So I think it is literally just grab Buddy Buddy. We're going to get a Finizen and Morpeko out. I wouldn't mind having an out for Pecherant. But I don't know that we need it. Let's do that. We'll grab another Palafin. Get that. No energy for turn either is a little bit awkward. But next turn, we do have another read I could use for like an Earthen Vessel in a pinch. I think we'll likely just go for Iono though. You wouldn't be able to view while playing because you're on mobile, but that's understandable. Yeah, that's all good. I asked other streamers and they panted a few games. And you played a few games. No, it didn't sound weird. It's just, yeah, kind of a. I hope this doesn't sound weird, but yeah, I don't see value in doing viewer matches to a degree. Like I'm happy to talk about lists. I'm happy to test them out, but like playing a game one-on-one against you, it can kind of slow down the pace of the stream, right? Like it's almost like I'm coaching you through the match. So if you're in here listening to what I'm saying, it's going to look like I'm doing poorly because it's like, well, he's doing the things exactly as I'm telling you. It just doesn't, I don't know. I don't think it makes for very interesting content. So I try and avoid doing that. We hop into these games. I chat with chat. I don't really do viewer matches. But there is people that do them. Like I know Sunny in his streams, he does a lot of viewer games. I think Just Seto does a lot of viewer matches. Like, yeah, there is people that will do that. No, I've been loving the TikToks recently. That's also how you found this channel. Ah, love it, man. Love it. I like making them. There's a bunch of new cards. I've just got to get around to actually like doing the recordings for the new stuff that got revealed. Because there's like Latios EX. What was the other stuff? I think we've gotten some new A-specs that I need to catch up on. It's usually like my Saturday afternoon. I just bang out a bunch of recordings, edit them, and then just like drip feed them through the week. So I'll get some more recorded and up there soon. Because yeah, I don't think there's any more scheduled at the moment. We've got this though. This, and I do have YouTube too, Yonoa, if you want some like long form content. Alolan Executor EX seems kind of nutty too, especially in Trago. Could definitely be pretty spicy to play with, right? Yeah, off this, it's, I need too many things, right? If I get Switch, I can do the pivot, but I don't have an energy. I think we do have to go for the Iono play here. Lost Vac isn't doing anything for us right now. Pheasant Dippity isn't a bad call, but as soon as I take a prize, it's a one shot for Charizard, so we don't bench it until we're able to actually use it. So yeah, we'll go Iono. Hopefully we get into Pecherant and an energy. That's exactly what I said I needed. Thanks for listening, game. You're swell. Yeah, attach that on there. Pecherant can bounce some more Peko into the active, no issues. And I guess, like, hindsight, I could have just used Switch. I didn't need to put this into play. It has the same logic of not putting a 2-prizer in play as why I just said we didn't put Pheasant Dippity in play, and then I went ahead and did it. And you know what? That's on me. Chuck another Finizen down, though. Punch out the Ghost. At least they can't fix up damage right now. So yeah, it's if they Gust kill Pecherant, it resets our Palafin. I don't need to use Switch. I also can't one-shot the Zard, though. I think this is Palafin's biggest, like, drawback. Is, yeah, getting up to stage 2 killing numbers. Shrouded been into anything but the Pokemon TCG recently? Who, me? Off stream? Oh yeah, heaps. On streams, though, I kind of just keep it to the one thing. I don't want to confuse the community. But we do, yeah, Wednesdays is kind of like standard. Fridays, I do the budget build battle tournament. So it's the triple B format. Because branding. So it's no rule box cards, so no Radiance, no A specs, no Vs, no EXs, and a limitation of just two copies of a card with the same name in your deck, just to kind of make for some more creative deck building. But yeah, off stream, I've been playing heaps of Hearthstone. I play a lot of Battlegrounds, and then at the moment, other than that, not too much actually. I garden a lot. It's winter here though. In Australia, we've been getting heaps of rain, so no gardening at the moment. And I've been training for a half marathon at the moment too. Which isn't good. My legs are a bit dead today. First ring popping up in the chat. Ooh, bear with me for a second, guys. Just bear with me. You just uninstalled Hearthstone last week? Why is that? You weren't enjoying it or just didn't have time? Okay, so they checked to collapse Stadium down. You know what? Fair. That's a good card. I honestly wouldn't mind running that in this deck too, because like we tank a hit, we can bounce it off our bench. But yeah, we'll proc this. We get the free pivot. And we punch him in the face. I don't know if you guys know this, but dragons absolutely hate getting punched in the face. And that makes me happy. So we're punching Charizard. We have the right to bear arms. But like, where are you gonna hang up? Where would bear arms look good? You can't put them on a mantle, it just looks awkward. And if you make a mantle out of them, people will think you're a monster. It's just silly. Wasn't enjoying the meta at all. You played standard. Oh, fair. That's fair. Okay. Yeah, I just played Battlegrounds. I put zero money into Hearthstone. Because they used to have it that you could buy the like the upgrade for Battlegrounds to have access to like four options of heroes that you could use in-game currency. And if you did like the ladder, like the season pass each month, you were able to just like keep buying it. And now they make you pay money. And I'm like, that's fine. I'll just pick between two heroes. I'm putting no money into that game. It's just like a very casual, like, I don't know, something to do on the side. Okay. Pecherant, do the thing. Yeah, you did the thing. Evolve it? Absolutely. What do I have that could do? How much do we need to do? 80? I don't have any, like, good backup attackers for that. We can get him charged up, or get him evolved up, I mean. Pivot into that. I could even use Earthen Vessel right now to get another dark energy on this and make it a threat, right? Which I might go for. Pop him up and pop him in the face. Oh, I'd love punching Charizard in the face. Everybody needs a hobby and that's mine. Classic Blizzard move? Nah, I'm like, it's fair. It is a fair thing. With the amount of time I sink into that game, I probably should be giving them money. But it's like, $25? Nah, like $10, I'd happily do that. Happily give them $10 every like 2 months. It's like PTCGL. If they charge for the battle pass in this game, happy to do it, right? The premium battle pass should be paid. It should $5-$10, make it so that they can actually bring in developers that'll put effort into the game and keep upgrading it. And as like updates are needed that they're rolled out and in like a timely manner, yes, I will give you $10. $25 though? No. I don't understand why they didn't monetize it. It doesn't make sense. The amount of money people throw into like just randomly opening booster packs, like that's gambling, guys. The battle pass is at least, you know what you're getting. Like, make it a paid thing, Maybe increase the amount of like full art trainers, or make it so that you get more crafting material out of it. And good to go. I think they're struggling. Yeah, they're definitely struggling. I just get around that, right? I Pecherant, I bring more Peko active, I move him again. All right. Charmander's running. That's fair. That is fair. They're just gonna go Rotom. Hope to get into a rare candy, get back online, or get back into the match. I need boss. That's not it. But judging their hand away, that's pretty good. That is pretty good. 60 damage for each prize card your opponent's taken. So if we make it that they take 4, we're not doing enough. But I guess the fact that this is then a threat that I could boss kill Rotom. Yes, that is good. Don't need to use the switches. So yeah, we'll just judge. Oh. Well. We bully? I think we just bully. Not sure why I hesitated for a second there. I was like waiting for them to pick a thing. I'm like, no, it's not escape rope. I could have gone for the Rotom. Just because then it's like I can literally boss up any single prizer and it would be game. But I think taking the ability for them to get a Charizard out is pretty big, right? Because now it means next turn they're doing absolutely nothing. What's your favorite card from Shrouded Fable? No, your favorite new card is Haxorus. Really? Really? I like it. Have you built a deck with it? Or like you slotted him into Regidrago? Because you said there's like a big Lugia scene at your locals, right? It's like, I feel like Haxorus is an instant include in Regidrago if there's a lot of Lugia running around. All right, so they got double Charmander out now. Concerning. They are resetting our Palafin again for us, though. Okay, like we get there regardless. I could do it myself, but if they want to help, I'm not going to say they can't. And we just judge that away again. Are we getting to the point though where they'll one-shot us? Because he does 180, 30 extra for each prize, so that's plus 150. Come on, math. 280, 320. So no, he would need a damage modifier, which defines banned. Okay. Bit scary. A little bit scary. I could put Pherazepsy down. I'm gonna put Pherazepsy down. We might need draw power. If they get back into this, we might need draw power. Well, I found two boss, so kind of tempted to just pass, to be honest. Right, I knocked that out. Bad times. Charizard potentially one-shots us with Defiance Band. Right now, Charizard isn't able to one-shot us. They don't have any Dusclops or anything on the bench to modify the damage. It's literally just, if I can hold this hand, I have game. Yep. I'm fine with that. I don't want to go down to one prize. That makes them too strong. Regidrago is the main thing you have to get rid of in games with randoms nowadays. Ah. Missed energy blocks Haxorus attack though. True. Oh, of course they have Iono. Of course they had Iono. All right, I guess I should have taken the prize. That's fine. I don't think they got much off of it. Doesn't seem like they're going anywhere fast. Yep, Rotom. Okay, cool. I need to get another one of him out, though. Okay. Finding nothing off of it. It's not what I wanted to see. Maybe I just attack with a Pecherant. Let's play it safe. I keep the big boy on the bench. I guess going with the big guy that, yeah, they wouldn't have been able to deal with him in one shot. That was the logic. Going with the Pecherant though means I get to keep the Palafin, who is going to be able to double tap into the Charizard. Even if Palafin dies, you can still boss KO the Rotom with Pecherant though. True. Well, I could have. I can't now. Don't have boss. We have shuffled the deck, though, so the bosses should be mixed in there. If they take a knockout, we Pheasant Dippity, we hopefully get into the boss, we have game. If they evolve Charizard here, Charizard takes a knockout into Pecherant. If they can get into a boss, they knock out Pheasant Dippity. Yeah, I should have put Palafin in the active. I should have had Palafin in the active. This is a bit of a Goomba moment on my part. What stadium in play? Collapse Stadium. It's a little tricky when they're all gold. Yeah, so it makes it so we can only have four things. I guess they hit nothing off of this? What's going on, Zard? Like, I like beating up Zard, but not like this. Poor Zard. It's what it is, I guess. Gotta love boss. It's a good card. It's a good card. Hey guys, thanks for sticking around to the end of the video. I hope you enjoyed the deck. And if you want to give it a go for yourself, it will be in the description of the video. Also, if you made it this far and you're not already subscribed, what are you doing? Just boop that button. Also, YouTube thinks you'll like these videos too. So maybe click on one of these if you're after another deck list or try and catch me live over on Twitch. But till next time, take care of yourselves.